In this video, we will study about amino acids. Amino acids, these are monomer unit of polymer proteins. Monomer means a single unit. And a polymer, many such single unit, they combine to form a polymer. For example, say this is a chain which is made up of many monomer unit. So this is a polymer protein, and each unit of this chain is a monomer, that is amino acid. Amino acid are organic micromolecules, and we know that micromolecules are those molecules which are having the molecular weight less than 1000 Dalton. Amino acids are substitute methane. We know the structure of the methane. One carbon having four hydrogen attached to this. In amino acid, one hydrogen is replaced by alkyl group, one hydrogen by carboxyl group, one carbon by amino group, and one is hydrogen. So there is one acidic group, one basic group. So overall nature of amino acid is neutral. But it is not that all amino acids are neutral. Depending on the nature of this R, there can be neutral amino acid. It can be acidic amino acid, or it can be a basic amino acid. For example, in this amino acid, instead of alkyl group, there is hydrogen. This is glycine. In another one, methyl group. So this is alanine. In another amino acid, there is hydroxyl group, serine, but if R is replaced by sulfur containing derivative, then this becomes a basic amino acid. And if there is an additional carboxyl group, then this becomes acidic amino acid, aspartic acid. So I think it is very much clear that from this R group, we decide the nature of amino acid. There are 20 such amino acids in our body which are responsible for making all the proteins in our body. Out of these 20 amino acids, some may be synthesized by our body, some may not be. So the amino acids which are not synthesized body, they are known as essential amino acids. Why these are essential? Because we require these amino acids in our diet. And there are 9 such essential amino acids. These are leucine, isoleucine, histidine, methionine, lysine, histidine, phenylalanine. Valine, tryptophan, and threonine. These are 9 essential amino acids. Now next thing, how these monomers, they combine to form a polymer protein by peptidyl linkage. What is this peptidyl linkage? Let us draw 2 amino acid. Let us write R here only. You can replace it by any group according to your wish. Now, the hydroxyl group of carboxyl group and hydrogen of this amino group, they undergo condensation. And a water molecule is released and this linkage is formed. Now this linkage is called peptidyl linkage. This is peptidyl linkage. So with the help of this linkage, many amino acids, they form a long protein. This protein may have hundreds, thousands of such amino acids. By this peptidyl linkage, they may form dipeptide having 2 amino acids or oligopeptides. Oligo means few amino acids, though simply we say peptide. Peptide means few amino acids. There are certain other words also beside this peptide, that is protease and peptones. Protease and peptones, these are again amino acid smaller chains which are formed by the hydrolysis of or digestion of proteins. Another very important property shown by amino acid is that they exist as Zwitter ions. Now what are Zwitter ions? The word Zwitter means hybrid or amphoteric. Amphoteric, both, a molecule that shows both positive as well as negative ion. One end is having the positive ion, another end is having the negative ion. So overall it is neutral. As in case of amino acid, the carboxyl can show the negative and amino group positive, and overall it is neutral. At isoelectric point. Now what is isoelectric point? This is the specific pH. Specific pH at which this Zwitter ion exists as the neutral ion. But when there is low pH, at low pH there are lots of hydrogen ions. So the amino group, this will accept the hydrogen ion and this will form the positive ion. So in such case, this acquire a positive charge. On the other hand, when there is high pH means lots of hydroxyl ion. Now what will happen? Now carboxyl group, this will give its hydrogen that will combine with hydroxyl to form water. So this will acquire a negative charge and now this will exist like this. So whether it will exist as negative or positive or neutral, it all depends on the pH of the solution.